Good morning students. So today discuss about mechanical properties of the fluids. So this is a intermediate first year chapter. So this is a video number 3, applications of Pascal's law. So here in this video some problems and applications of the Pascal's law. So there are two major applications, that is one is hydraulic lift, another is hydraulic brakes. So now I'll explain hydraulic lift. So now here I am taking Pascal's law. So we know that Pascal's law. So what is meaning of the Pascal's law? Here I am taking one cylinder. This is a one cylinder. So the cylinder is having the piston. So this is a piston. Right? So this is a piston. It is having one cylinder. The inside of the cylinder or container, it is a liquid is there or fluid is there, fluid. Okay, so here when the force F1, the force is acting on this particular area capital A, so therefore the pressure is acting, what is the pressure? P is equal to F by A, the force per unit area, pressure is acting. So here the pressure is transported inside of the fluids is equally, here this is the pressure is transported in all direction, all surface are equally. So this is called another Pascal's law. So if an external pressure is applied in this enclosed fluid, they're transmitted, the transmitted to every point, transmitted to every point in the fluids, undiminished. So this is called, the pressure is transported or transmitted to every point in the fluids, undiminished. So this is called Pascal's law. This is called Pascal's law. The pressure is equally on the layers. So that is, pressure is constant here. The pressure is constant. What happened? F by A is equal to constant. Okay. So therefore, the F by A is equal to constant means F is directly proportional to A. So the area will be more. The pressure also, force also more. So therefore here I will writing F1 by A1 is equal to F2 by A2. Okay, this is a one of the relation in the Pascal's law where the pressure is constant. So here what is the application? I am taking the hydraulic lift. So this is a one of the hydraulic lift and the hydraulic brakes. So two application. Okay, so this hydraulic lift is depends on the Pascal's law. It is a depends on the Pascal's law. Okay. So in this hydraulic lift, so this is a diagram. Okay. So here I am taking, so this hydraulic lift consists of two pistons. So this is the first piston, this is the second piston. The area of the piston, first one A1 area, the second piston, so this is a complete area, A2 area, and so this is a setup, it is filled with liquid, this is a complete one liquid or fluid, filled with liquid, one liquid, maybe anyone fluid is liquid is there. So this is the area of the cross section A1, one piston is there, and this is the second piston. So their area where A1 is very small cross-sectional area and this is a A2 is very high. So what happened in this hydraulic lift? The hydraulic lift mainly using the lift of heavy objects, example cars, buses and motor vehicles, the lift of the heavy object by using of the hydraulic lift. So here how to working of this hydraulic lift? In this one, their force F1 is acting on the piston F1. What happened? The F1 force is acting on the piston one. So we know that this is the area of the cross section. The force per unit area, what happened? The pressure is producing, that is P is equal to F by A1. So according to Pascal, what happened here? This is a pressure. Okay, pressure is developed. So this pressure is a transport inside of the liquid. The pressure is transported inside of the liquid. So at the second piston, the force is acting in the upward direction. So how much force is acting due to this pressure? Their force is acting F2. Okay, so therefore here this pressure is transported in this liquid. So it is another part through the liquid. So how much upward force is acting? This is the upward force. The upward force is acting on the second piston. So how much force is acting? So force F is equal to pressure into area. F2 is equal to pressure into area A2. Okay, what is the upward forces acting in the second piston? F2 is equal to P into A2. So therefore F2 is equal to P is equal to F1 by A1 into A2. So therefore what is the force here? F2 is equal to F1 A2 by A1. So how much force is acting at this piston? F1 is equal to A2 by A1. So where A2 by A1 is called, A2 by A1, it is a factor, is called mechanical advantage of hydraulic lift, the mechanical advantages of hydraulic lift. So when their area or force will be changes, so this force also will be changed. So what is your observation in this one? A very small amount of force is acting on a piston small surface area. The F2 force is acting is more. Very large force is acting. So how much large force is acting? This is the F2 is equal to F1 into A2 by A1. So where A1 is very very small with compared to A2, so therefore the large force is applied to on the second piston. So therefore it is a lift to the heavy object. The large piston is capable of lifting bodies like cars, etc. So this is called as hydraulic lift. So when the small force is applied on one side, another side the force larger will be acting. So therefore the lift of heavy object, so this is called as hydraulic lift. Second application, hydraulic brakes. So in this hydraulic brakes in the automobiles also depends on principle of Pascal's law. In this hydraulic brakes, what happened? Very small force is applied on a pedal with foot. The larger force is applied on a four wheels of the tires. So therefore their car or any object will be stopped. So here I will explain with respect to diagrams. So this is a diagram. So the diagram is complicated, so I show the textbook. So here this is a brake pedal. So this is a complete hydraulic brakes. So in this one the hydraulic brakes, so this is a brake fluid and brake lining, brake shoes. So this is other wheel, four wheels is there. So this is a drum. So this is a brake pedal. So when we apply the force on the brake pedal, what happen? First you can apply the very small force on the pedal. So this piston is moving towards inside of the master cylinder. What happened? So the piston, this piston is moving in the master cylinder. This is a moving in the master cylinder. So what happened? The force is acting on this very small force, the small area. Their pressure is acting. This pressure is transmitted in the fluid here. This one, brake fluids. So when this pressure is transmitted to another pistons or another area of the piston, what happened? These piston is expanding. Okay, so their area is more, they're expanding. So what happened? This brake shoes also expanding with respect to brake lines. The brake shoes is expanding. So therefore, what happened in this one? So suddenly the brakes will be applied on a wheel. So this is a setup. It is having four wheels. Here this is the first wheel and second wheel and third wheel and fourth wheel. When the very small force is applied, the pressure will be transmitted in the brake fluids. So now is going to this one transmitted. What happened? It is expanding. The brake shoes will be expanding with respect to brake lines. What happened? These brake lines will be stop the car. So in this four wheel system, especially in the cars, their force will be equally spreaded. So therefore the car will be stopped is very sharply. So this is called hydraulic brakes. This is also second application of the Pascal's law. Here I am explaining some exercise problems. So this is a test book problem. So Telugu Academy test book, especially in the Telangana. So example 11.2, what is the pressure on a swimmer 10 meters below the surface of a lake? Here solutions. So here this is a one surface of lake. This is a one lake. Here one swimmer is there. So at what depth is there the swimmer? 10 meters below the surface. So what is my question? At this swimmer 10 meter depth, how much pressure is acting? This is my question. How much pressure is acting? So we know that the pressure, the total pressure P is equal to P naught plus rho g h or h rho g. So where P naught is equal to atmosphere pressure, we know that P naught is equal to atmosphere pressure, ATM pressure. ATM means atmosphere pressure. What is the value? This is a constant value. 1.01 into 10 power 5 Pascal. Okay, so this value is, we know that. And rho is equal to density of the water. Okay, what is the rho? So density of water. So always taking the density of the water, 1000 or 10 cube kg per meter cube. It is also constant. Density of the water, 1000 or 10 cube kg per meter cube. So here, and I want to g value, I am taking g is equal to 10 meter per second square. Okay, if you're taking 9.8 also. If you're taking the 9.8, the answer is very small changes. So the calculation purpose, I am taking g is equal to 10. Substitute in this equation. So p is equal, what is the p naught? 1.01 into 10 power 5 plus rho, density, 10 cube, I will write to 10 cube, g, 10. And h, we know that 10 meters. So 1.01 into 10 power 5. So here 10 cube, here 1, 3, 4, 5. A power m into a power n into a power p, something like this. M and p. So a power 10 power 3 plus 1, 4 plus 1. 5, 10 power 5. So here 10 power 5 is there, 10 power 5 is there. I will write 1.01 into 10 power 5. So 10 power 5 means 1 into 10 power 5. I will write 1 into 10 power 5 also equal same of the 10 power 5. So here you can taking 10 power 5, same right now this 10 power 5 common. So 1.01 plus 1 into 10 power 5. So 1.01 plus 1, 2.01 into 10 power 5. So that is 2 into 1.01 into 10 power 5. So 1.01 into 10 power 5 is equal to 1 atmosphere. So therefore 2 atmosphere. 2 atmosphere. So here at 10 meter depth, how much pressure will be increases? 2 atmosphere pressure will be increases are 2 into 10 power 5 Newton per meters or Pascals pressure will be acting at the depth of 10 meters. You can calculate any one, 100 meter, 200 meter, 500 meters. Okay, so by using P is equal to P naught rho g h. Suppose P naught is not considered, sometimes the atmosphere will be neglected. What happened? What is the formula? P is equal to rho g h. Rho g h. So this is a solution of the 11.2 in the textbook. Next textbook problem 11.3. So the density of the atmosphere at sea level is 1.29 kg per meter cube. Assume that it does not change with altitude, then how high would the atmosphere extended? Here, so I am taking the earth, the density of the atmosphere, density of the atmosphere at the sea level. So what is the density of the atmosphere in the sea level? 1.29 kg per meter cube. Assuming that it does not change with altitudes, how high we can calculate h? So we know that P minus P naught is equal to rho gh. So this is a gauge pressure, change in pressure. Okay. So P is equal to P naught rho gh, or P minus P naught is equal to rho gh. This is called gauge pressure. So how much their pressure will be variation? This is P minus P naught is equal to atmosphere pressure. So P minus P naught is equal to 1.01 into 10 power 5 Pascal. I am taking, wire taking, where this is a P is external pressure, P naught is equal to atmosphere pressure. Change means complete atmosphere pressure. Complete atmosphere, I am consider only atmosphere pressure, because in this question the density of the atmosphere at the sea level is given. So how much change, the change pressure, I am taking completely atmosphere pressure. So I am taking 1.01 into 10 power 5. Rho, what is the rho value? 1.29 is given. G, I am taking 9.8. if you interested, you can taking 10 also, 9.8. and h, I don't know how much height. Okay, so therefore here, so what is the h value? H is equal to 1.01 into 10 power 5 by 1.29 into 9.8. so you can calculate. So what is the answer? 7989 meters. 7989 meters. So h is equal to, approximately h is equal to 8 kilometers. Okay, so what is that? 8 kilometers. So what is your observation in the reality? The density rho of air, density of air decreases with height. Height will be increased. So what is the density of the air? The density of the air is decreases. So here, always taking atmosphere pressure, not 760 mm. Don't to consider what is the atmosphere pressure at the sea level. Okay, at the sea level generally 760 millimeters of hg. Always it is not taking. So the different types of questions will be given, the different atmosphere pressure we can calculate it. So at what height extended? There is 8 kilometers. Next, 11.4. At a depth of 1000 meter in an ocean, what is the absolute pressure? What is the gauge pressure? Find force acting on the window of area 20 centimeter into 20 centimeter of submarine at this depth. Here 11.4 solution. So this is one ocean. Okay, so what is the three questions is there? First one, at height 100 meter, what is the absolute pressure at height h is equal to 1000 meters? Find absolute pressure, P calculate. First one, so we know that P is equal to P naught plus rho gh. So P naught, we know that 1.01 into 10.5 Pascal plus rho, density is given. So here in this one, there are density rho, the density of the sea water is given 1.03 into 10 cube kg per meter cube, and g is also given 10 meter per second square. So therefore here rho density, what is the density? 1.03 into 10 cube into g is equal to 10 is given, h is equal to 1000 meters 10 cube. So you can calculate. Okay, finally you can get 104 atmosphere. Okay, you can calculate homework, calculate finally 104 atmosphere. And the second one, gauge pressure. Okay, gauge pressure. So what is the gauge pressure? P minus P naught is equal to PT. This is a change the pressure. Okay, the atmosphere pressure and original pressure is a change. It's give the gauge pressure. So P minus P naught is equal to PG is equal to rho GH or H rho G. So in this case, how to calculate PG? PG is equal to same. This complete value. Okay, so that is same. You can taking 1.03 into 10 cube into 10 into 10 cube. So here this is a PG, it's give the answer 103 atmosphere. Okay, 103 atmosphere. You can calculate, you can compulsory can get 103 atmosphere, because here 104, this is 103 plus 104, like that. So this is the second one. And third one will be different. What is the different one? Submarine is there. Submarine inside of the waters. Okay, so this is using especially in the inside of the waters. Okay, the submarine always inside of the water. These submarines is having one window. So what is question? At this window, how much force is acting of the fluids or sea water? At this window, how much force is acting? So but area is equal to, so how much is given area? 20 centimeter into 20 centimeter. Okay, area is given. So when the submarine inside of the water, so what happen, how much pressure will be acting? That is equal to PG, gauge pressure, because so this is a one atmosphere pressure. Okay, so P naught, so inside water pressure P. So how much variation of the pressure is acting on this window? That is equal to PG. So PG is equal to rho GH. So we know that PG is equal to rho GH. What is the answer? 103 atmospheres. Okay, 103 atmosphere. Okay, 1 atmosphere here. 103 into 10 power 5 Pascal. This is a PG. Okay, so this is a window. Okay, what is the area of the window? Area is equal to 20 centimeter into 20 centimeter. Conversions compulsory meters. Okay, so 20 into centimeter. 1 centimeter, how many meters? 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. 1 centimeter is equal to 10 power minus 2 meters. So 20 centimeter is equal to 20 into 10 power minus 2 meters. Here 20 into 10 power minus 2 meters. Okay, so 20 into 10 power minus 2, so that is 0.2 meters into 0.2 meters. So finally 0.2 into 0.2, 0.04 meters. What is the area of the window? This is a 0.04 meter. So how much force is acting at this window? So that is equal to So force formula, F force is equal to Pg into A. Okay. So pressure is equal to force per unit area. Therefore, force is equal to Pg. While taking the Pg, the change the pressure here. The atmosphere pressure in the upper, in the submarine, the liquid pressure is also acting. How much change? I am taking Pg. So therefore, Pg is equal to, so 103 into 10 power 5 Pascal into 0.04. We can calculate finally 4.12 into 10 power 5 Newton. So how much force is acting inside the submarines? 4.12 into 10 power 5 Newtons. Next problem, hydraulic lift problem. Two syringes of different cross section A1, A2 and length L1, L2 without two needles, filled with water, are connected with a tightly fitted rubber tube filled with water. Diameter of the smaller piston and larger piston 1 cm, 3 cm respectively. Find force exerted on the larger piston when the force is 10 Newton is applied to the smaller piston. Second one, if the smaller piston is pushed in through 6 cm, how much does the large piston moves out? Here solution 11.5. So I am taking two syringes, injections. We know that very well, these syringes. So one is a very small area of the cross section. So what is the area of the cross section? So this is a A1 I am taking. The area of the cross section 1 cm is given. And the second one, another syringe is a area of the cross section 3 cm is given. Okay, so it is a tight with a rubber pipe. The rubber pipe is having some water. So what happens, suppose when the force, first question, F1 force is acting, how much, that is a 10 Newton is applied here. There force F1, the 10 Newton is applied. What happened? This syringe is moving in the downward. There pressure is moving like this. So therefore the force is acting in this syringe. The syringe, the force is, how much force is acting? This is my question. Okay. So we know that by using hydraulic concept, F2 is equal to F1 into A2 by A1. A2 by A1. A2, A1 is the area of the cross sections. Area of the cross section. But in this case, it is not area of the cross section. It is give the, sorry, diameters. Diameter is given. Sorry, it is not area of the cross section. It is a diameter is given. So what happened? So F1 is equal to 10 Newtons. What is the area? Diameter 3 cm. What is the radius? Radius is equal to 3 by 2 cm. And what is the area? A is equal to pi r square formula. So that is A2 is equal to pi into, I am taking this is R2. So that is pi into, what is the R2? 3 by 2 cm. I am conversion meter, 10 power minus 2 meters. Okay, 3 cm, 3 by 2 cm radius. 3 by 2 into 10 power minus 2 meters by same similarly pi by here. What is the diameter? 1 centimeter. What is the radius? 1 by 2 centimeter. Centimeter conversion to meter, 10 power minus 2 meters. Pi r square square. So this is everything is cancelled. Here the square. So 10 power minus 2. 2i into 2, so 10 into 3, so what happened, 10 into 3, 30, 3 square here, 3 square, after square I will cancel each other, so what happened, 10 into 9, 19 Newtons, okay, don't cancel is directly, after squaring, it is a cancel, finally, right, so 10 into 3 square, 19 Newton. So what is your observation in this syringe? Only 10 Newton force will be applied. How much force is acting in the second syringe? 19 Newton. So therefore, very small force is applied. The large force is generated on the second piston. So this is concept about of a hydraulic lift. Second one here, what is the question? Second one. Second question, if this piston is moving through only 6 cm. So actually, I don't know this is, but the piston is moving here to here. How much? 6 cm is moving downward, where piston is area of the cross section is moving the downward 6 cm. How much area of the cross section is moving in the second siren? So in this case, I am taking, so both are water is considered to perfectly incompressible. Their both volume will be covered equal. Here I am taking both volume is covered equal. What is the formula of the volume? Length into area. Length into area, general formula. So that is, I am taking volume of the first syringe, L1 length, A1 area. And second one, L2 length, A2 area. So what is the L1 length? I want to L2. How much length will be moving up? So L2 is equal to L1 into A1 by A2. So what is the L1? L1 is equal to, so we know that 6 cm. 6 means 6 into 10 power minus 2 meters. And here, we know that very well, this is a pi into, what is the A1? 1 by 2, 10 power minus 2 meter whole square by pi into 3 by 2 into 10 power minus 2 meter whole square. Pi pi cancel. It is a squaring after. So finally, you can get 0.67 into 10 power minus 2 meters. So finally 0.67 centimeters. Okay, so what is that? Finally 0.6 centimeters. So how much their length will be moving? 0.67 centimeters. Next one, in a car lift, compressed air exert a force F1 on a small piston having a radius 5 cm. This pressure is transmitted to second piston of radius 15 cm. So if the mass of the car to be lifted 1350 kg, calculate F1. What is the pressure necessary to accomplish this task? G is equal to 9.8 m². Here simple. So this is some small diagram. So here some radius of the piston 5 cm. This is the radius of the piston 15 cm. One car is there. At this second one, now what is the weight of the car? 1350 kg. So what is the question? How much force is applied? How much force is applied? We know that the force is applied, the pressure is transmitted like this. Okay, so that is F1 is equal to, what is the formula? A1 by A2 is equal to F2. So A1 is equal to, we know that A1 is equal to, R is given, pi R square, pi R1 square. So pi into R1, 5 centimeter. So 5 into 10 power minus 2 meters whole square, R1. And pi R2 square, A2 is equal to pi 15 into 10 power minus 2 meter whole square. But what is the force on the second piston? I don't know, but 1350 kg given. So F2 is equal to force is equal to mass into acceleration generally. So that is M. What is the mass? 1350 kg. G is equal to 9.8. So you can get 1350 into 9.8. So it's give some value. It is the F2 value. So substitute A1. That is 5 into 5, 10 power minus 2 meters whole square, pi into 15 into 10 power minus 2 whole square into 1350 into 9.8. You can calculate. So pi pi cancel, please calculate. Okay, so you can get the answer. What is the answer? 1.5 into 10 cube newtons. 1.5 into 10 cube newtons. So here, how much force is applied on this one? 15. 10 cube means 1500 newtons. Also you can write 1500 newtons. And what is the second question? How much pressure, air pressure, is acting? So that is P is equal to F1 by A1. F1 by A1. What is the F1? F1 is equal to 1.5 into 10 cube newton. What is the A? a pi into 10 power minus 2 whole square meters. You can calculate 1.9 into 10 power 5 Pascal. Okay, this is a double 1.9. Let us take 2. 2 into 10 power 5, 2 atmosphere, double of the atmosphere. This is a air pressure that will produce this force. So this is a video about hydraulic lifts, hydraulic brakes, and some examples, problems, and solutions of mechanical properties of fluids. Thank you, one and all.